Okay, my Dilanas over there, I congratulate you upon finishing the other topic, which was reproduction. That was under the theme of human body. So I congratulate you upon doing moving with me, and we finished that topic. It was so interesting. So we are eagerly waiting to open another new topic. But as usual, I am your teacher Hakim, and we always start with our word bank. So this is lesson number 24. Our word bank, it is here waiting for us. Okay, let us start with our word number one. So this word number one is read as amoeba. This one is read as amoeba, and we say that this amoeba, it is a unicellular organism under what we call the protozoan. And again, this amoeba, it behaves like a white blood cell. So it has this outer covering, which is called the cell membrane. So its outer covering is called the cell membrane. Now it has the next one, the lining on it here. This is what we call the ectoplasm. This one is called the ectoplasm. Then inside here, it is what we call the endoplasm. So this is called the endoplasm. Then at the center here, it has the nucleus. As we always discuss, we say that this nucleus controls all the activities taking place within a cell. Then it has this part here, and this part is what we call the food vacuole. It is called the food vacuole. It is there for digesting food, and also has this one for engation, which is called the contractile vacuole. It is called the contractile vacuole. Then vacuole, then it has these ones. These are what we call false legs, and these false legs are called the pseudopodia. So what does an amoeba used to move? It uses the pseudopodia, and when it is one, it is called pseudopodium. Then podia legs, pseudo means false, so they are false legs. So then again, those are false legs. Then this one is a germ. It is a pathogen which can cause what we call an amoebic dysentery, and that type of amoeba is called entamoeba istolytica. Okay, so this one is read as coccidiosis. This one is read as coccidiosis. It is also a protozoan disease. This disease can attack the poultry. It can attack the rabbits, and also can attack poultry and rabbits. That is coccidiosis. And this is leucosis. This one is read as leucosis. So it is coming from the word called avian leucosis, and this is in simple terms is called the bird flu. It is caused by a virus. So we have other word here, liquid. The word is liquid. The word is a liquid, like a cooking oil, like water, like a paraffin, like a petrol, like a porridge. All those ones are liquids. So it is a state of matter. Now we have this other word. This is called read as a cylinder. It is read as a cylinder from what we called the measuring cylinder, which we used during the displacement method to get a volume of an irregular object. Okay, so now here we have this other word. This word is called solitary. This one is read as solitary. It is read as a solitary. So the opposite of solitary is social. When you look at mosquitoes, when you look at cockroaches, when you look at when you look at butterflies, all these insects are solitary insects, meaning that they don't live, move, and work together like the bees, like the sassafras, like the grasshoppers. So these ones are like the grasshoppers, like the bees, like the white ants, like the termites, the savali ants. So those ones are social insects. They move, work, and live together. Okay, so here we have this word, potassium, and this word disturbs very many. Potassium. The word is potassium. Some of you make a double T here. No, it is SS. So potassium, this is a mineral salt. Do you know when we lose this mineral salt? We lose this mineral salt during the condition called dehydration, when we have severe vomiting and severe diarrhea. That's why a person is given ORS with the salt. So the salt to replace the lost mineral salts, one of them is potassium, another one is sodium. These ones, they don't strengthen the bones, neither the teeth, but they help in transmission of nerve impulses. Then we have this other word here. This word is exert. This word is exert. Exert means to put, like air exerts pressure, meaning that air puts pressure on things. Then lastly, you have this word occupy. The word is occupy, or the word is occupy. Then when we want it to be occupied, then we are going to put P-I-E-S. The word becomes occupies. Okay, my dear learners, the words are occupy, exert, potassium, solitary, cylinder, liquid, leucosis, coccidiosis, and amoeba. So this has been our word bank for today. Now, as I told in the previous session, in this session also we are not going to have a science diagram, but we are going to have a calculation or calculations. Now, these calculations, they are going to be then basing on mass, volume, and density. Mass, volume, and density. Now, in the previous lessons, we've been looking at mass, and we've said mass is the quantity of matter a body contains. Mass is the quantity of matter a body contains. Then again, volume, this is the total space, the total space occupied by an object, whereas volume is the result of mass and density. So density is the result of volume and mass. So density is the mass per unit volume. So we are now going to look at the calculations. For example, let us get number one here. They can tell us that a body of mass 60 grams has a density has a density of 10 grams per cc. Find its volume. Now, when you are calculating this one, we are going to use a simple triangle like the one we used in mathematics, the Queen of Uganda. But here we are not using the Queen of Uganda. We are going to say many voti multiplied dogs. Now we are going to put it here, many voti multiplied dogs, whereby many mass. So mass is equal to volume times density. Now if I want to get this is many voti multiplied dogs. If I want density, so density will be mass over volume. And if I want to get what is the remaining, if I want to get volume, this is many voti multiplied dogs. So now volume, so volume is equal to what is up here, mass over what? A density. So this is how we use our triangle, many voti multiplied dogs. Now we come, what are they asking? They want us to get the volume. Now we are going to use the formula. Now in these questions we use the formula, but those questions where we have the displacement method, we have the measuring cylinders, we have the eureka, we don't use the formula. We just read from the cylinder, as in the first level, second level, we subtract it, or we read the directed. Now but when we are in word form like this one, we are using the formula. So main volt multiplied dogs. So what is volume? So volume is equal to mass over the density. So what is our mass from the question? It is 60 grams. Divide by what is our density? This is 10 grams per cc. So gram will go with the gram, zero with a zero. So we get a 6 with cc. So a volume is 60 cc. Or if you want to show more mathematics here, you can tell us that volume is equal to mass over density, which is 60 grams divided by the division bar, becomes division sign, 10 grams per cc. Then this is going to be 60 grams, then times cc over 10 grams, because when you are dividing, we use SR, if you know that mathematics. Then the gram will go with a gram, 0 with a 0, 6 times cc, then we get 60 cc. This is how we come up with the cc. CC stands for a cubic centimeters. Because volume is measured in cubic units, they can be cubic meters, cubic centimeters, cubic decimeters, like that. Whereas mass is measured in grams, if not grams, it is measured in kilograms. So now density is the result of what we have divided. If mass was in grams and volume was in cubic centimeters, then it becomes grams per cubic centimeters. If it was in kilograms and this is cc, then it becomes kilogram per cc, like that. Okay, so let us get another example. Then they can tell us that find the density of an object whose volume is 10 cc and mass 5 grams. So we are finding density. So what is our triangle saying? The triangle says main volt multiplied dogs. So we want dogs. So a density is equal to mass over volume. So what is our mass? Our mass is 5 grams divided by what is our density? What is our volume? 10 cc. So by 5 1 by 5 2. So we have 1 out of 2 up, we have grams, down we have cc, because dense have not cancelled. Then when we have, let us get number 2 here. The density of a log is 100 grams per centimeter cubed. What is its mass? What is its mass if its volume? If its volume is 40 cubic centimeters. Now what are they asking? Mass. So from our main volt multiplied dogs, so mass is equal to volume times density. So what is our mass? What is the volume from the question? The volume is 10 centimeters cubed times what is density? Density is 100 grams per minute divided cubic centimeters. Cubic centimeter with the cubic centimeter, 4 times 1, that is for adding our 3 zeros, 1, 2, 3. So we get 400 grams. Number 3 here. So we are given, now we are going to be given this table, I mean this diagram. They tell us that I started the diagram below and answer the questions that follow. So here they give us 10 centimeters, and here 5 centimeters, and here 2 centimeters. Then they tell us that find the mass of the figure above, if its density is 10 grams per centimeter cubed. Now what are they asking us to get? They want us to get the mass. Why would we get mass? Volume times density. But do we know the volume? We don't know the volume, but we can get the volume, right? Why? Because this is a regular object. Now how do you get the volume of a regular object? We use the formula method, that is base area times height. So what is the base area? Length times width times its what? Now what is that one? So 10 centimeters times 5 centimeters, then times 2 centimeters. So what are we getting here? 10 times this one, this is 50. 10, 5 times 2, 10. 10 times 10, that is 100 centimeters cubed as the volume. Remember, the density is at 10 grams per cc. So from there, now our volume is 100 centimeters cubed. Then our density is given as 10 grams per centimeters. Then they want us to get mass, which is volume times density, whereby what is volume? Now 100 centimeters cubed times 10 grams per centimeters cubed, centimeters with this one cubic, then that is 1000 grams. Okay, now they can give us also another here. They can say, use the diagram below. Use the diagram below to answer the questions that follow. Now they give us the diagram here, and this diagram, let me draw it. You'll excuse me, mine is not now here we are having this, and also we are having this, then we are having our stone within. Now this is our water within here. Now here they are going to tell us this one is the first level. Now this one is the second. Then we are having a 0, we have 10, here we have 20, we have 30, then we have 40. Now cc, then cc, then cc, then cc, then cc. Our first question, identify the method used So automatically the method is going to be the displacement method, right? So displacement method here. Then two, they can tell us name the container. Name the container shown. Name the container there. So the container is going to become a measuring a cylinder. And why is this method used? Because this one has, you know, a regular as a shape, so it is an irregular object. Then what is the volume of the object? So what is the volume of the object? Now here we are not going to use the formula method. Here we are going to read. So we are going to get the second volume minus the first volume here, right? Now what is the second volume? When you look at this one, we are having intervals. This is 10, this is 20, 25, 30, 35. Are you getting? So from mathematics, we looked at median. Between the number between 40 and 30 is going to be 35. So 35 cc minus the number between 10 and 20, it is 15, so minus 15 centimeters. Cubic meters. So 35 minus 15 is 0 and 2. So we remain with the 20 cc. Then part D, they can tell us if the object has 10 grams, find its density. Find its what? Density. So here now we are going to use the formula, because density, we can't read the density from here. No. So we are going to use our triangle, which is men vote multiplied dogs, right? So men multiply vote multiplied dogs, then density is equal to, now density here is equal to mass over volume. What is the mass? 10 grams. What is the volume we have obtained from here? It is 20 cc. Then 0 with a 0. So we have 1 out of 2 grams per cc. Okay, my Delana, I hope you've understood the way we do a search and numbers. Okay, so today in this lesson, we are now going to revisit what we call matter. We are going to revisit what we call matter. Now, if they ask what is matter, so matter is going to be defined in a very simple way. So matter is defined as anything or something. So matter is anything or something that has weight. So something that has weight and occupies a space. So anything that has weight and occupies what? A space. Meaning that matter takes volume, because we've said volume is the total space occupied by any object. So matter is anything that has weight and occupies a space. So, or we can say that matter is anything that has mass and weight. This one can also be a definition of matter. You can say matter is anything that has weight, and it is anything that occupies space and has weight, or anything that has mass and has weight. Remember, we said what is mass? We will say that mass is the quantity of matter a body contains. So is the amount of matter contained in any object. Then what is weight? Now let us discuss what you call a weight. Some people say that weight is the heaviness or lightness of an object. Oh gosh, no, we are going to define weight in a simple way. Now suppose here you are having a bag. Now a bag has a handle and you are carrying it. Now when you are carrying it, you have stones here. So as you are carrying the stones, you are feeling some force. You are putting in some energy, some force to support this bag. Why are you feeling that one? Because down here we have another force, and this force which is pulling this bag to come down is what we call gravity. That is what we call gravitational force. Now you are overcoming, meaning that you are fighting with gravity to prevent this bag from falling. That's why sometimes when you tie things or you hang things on a rope, then sometimes the rope breaks, meaning that now the gravity has overcome the force in the wati the rope, then it has pulled the things, thus the rope breaks, then the things fall down. Now that force you are putting in to support this bag, and say, hey, this bag is heavy, why? Now that is the march of gravity you are fighting with. So that is what you call weight. That is what you call what, my dear? Weight. So weight is defined as the gravitational force acting upon an object. I'm repeating, my dear Lana. Mm-hmm. Let me write it here as we are repeating together. Weight is the gravitational force. I've said what is weight. Weight is the gravitational what? Gravitational force acting on what? Acting on any object. Everybody there, we've said, let us take it together. Weight is the gravitational force acting upon any object. So weight is the gravitational force acting upon any object. Are we there? Have you understood that? That's very good. Now, and this weight, it is measured, it has units in which we measure it, and it is measured in the units called newtons. The units called what? Newtons. Say newtons, everybody there. Newtons. So good. Now, weight is measured in newtons. And now we have the machines, the instrument we use to measure weight. One, it is what we call a springy balance. A spring what? Balance. And also what we call the beam balance. But mainly we use a springy balance. Now this spring balance, if you have ever gone to where they sell poultry feeds, emery and koko, we batunda the wholesale or batundo buunga baina minzani eringe sawa. Now it has a hook, then it has numbers, then nepima. Now baluba muno, then gravity ne fighting, then this one, the spring inside here also balances the gravity. As it is balancing, then akalimi muri munda mu clock ne katambla ni wagamba it is now 20 either 20 newtons or 30 newtons. Now this is what we call weight. However much this one also measures the mass, but we can convert this mass into what we call weight by multiplying by 10 newtons. We shall see this one further in primary 7. Let us stop there. Now what I want you to understand is what is weight. We said weight is the gravitational force acting upon any object. Units we measure weight in newtons. Then the instrument we use to measure, that is the springy balance. Are we there? Mm-hmm. Now from there we've said matter is anything that has mass and volume. Then what is volume? So we say that volume is the total space occupied by any object. So total space occupied by any object, my dear Lana, are we still together? So you can define the following terms. Matter, we've said matter is anything that has weight and occupies space. What is weight? Weight is the gravitational force acting upon an object. Then what is volume? Volume is the total space occupied by any object. Then weight is measured in newtons, mass is measured in grams or kilograms, then volume is measured in cubic units. Are we getting that? Are we together? All right, that's good of you. Now let us look at what we call properties of matter. Properties of what? Properties of matter. Let us look at properties of matter. One, matter has weight. Mm-hmm. That is one property. Matter has weight. Actually, they will ask you, why is carbon dioxide called matter? Why do we call carbon dioxide matter? Very simple. Carbon dioxide is called matter. Anything to be called matter, it has to be with weight. So you can tell us that carbon dioxide has weight. Carbon dioxide occupies space. So another property is that matter has weight and matter occupies space. Matter occupies a space. Then matter exerts pressure. Another property says matter exerts pressure. To exert means to put. So matter exerts pressure. So these are the properties of matter. And this matter is made up of small particles which we call molecules. So matter is made up of small particles, and these small particles we call them molecules. So matter is made up of small particles called molecules, but these molecules, they come from the smallest indivisible, those ones which we cannot divide. So smallest indivisible particles which we call atoms, meaning that if this is an atom, so when you have very many atoms, they are forming a big one which you call a molecule. So atom they form a molecule, atom they form a molecule. Then after that we are forming something occupying space which we call matter. So properties of matter are: matter has weight, matter occupies space, matter exerts pressure, and also matter is made up of small particles called Amalek was right. Are we there? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Now, let us go from here. Now, let us look at what we call states of matter. Uh-huh. So, states of matter. So, there are three states of matter. Namely, we have the liquid state. Two, we have the gaseous. Don't say gases. Gases, no, it is the gaseous state. And three, we have the solid state. The solid state of matter. So, matter is made up of small particles. Now, let us start with what we call the solid state. Mm-hmm. Let us get the properties of solids. One, these solids, they have a definite shape. They have a definite shape, a known shape. When you look at them, they have either you cannot, they have a definite shape. When you look at a ball, you look at a cylinder, you look at a tube, even those stones. However, the shape is irregular. Then they also have volume. They have a volume, meaning they occupy space. And three, their molecules are closely packed. This is very vital. Their molecules, those particles which build them, so their molecules are closely, they are closely packed. The molecules are closely packed together. The molecules are closely packed together. And number four, they have much cohesion forces. They have much cohesion forces. They have much cohesion forces. Now, we need to understand what cohesion is. Mm-hmm. Now, cohesion, let us first go and see how matter is built. We are having atoms. We said it starts with atoms. Now, these are the atoms. Now, these atoms make a molecule. Now, we get other atoms here. They make a molecule. Then, we have these atoms here. They make a molecule. Then, we have these atoms here. They make a molecule. Now, this molecule, it has a force. It attracts each. They attract themselves. This molecule attracts this molecule. Then, this one attracts this one. Then, this one attracts this one. Then, this one attracts this one. Then, this one can attract this one, as this one can also attract this one. Then, this one can also attract this, as this one is attracting this one. Then this one comes this way. So they keep on attracting each other. Now, these forces of attraction between these molecules, because these molecules are of the same substance, we are calling them cohesion. We are calling them cohesion forces. So cohesion forces are forces of attraction. They are forces of what? Attraction between what? Between molecules of the same substance. My dear learner, get it? Cohesion forces are forces of attraction between molecules of the same substance. Between molecules of the same substance. That's why we are saying that now. these molecules are closely packed because their forces of their cohesion forces are too strong, meaning that they are too close to each other here. That's why they don't flow. So the molecules are closely packed to each other. Now, if we are to draw the state, the solid state, and now this is our box, we are representing the arrangement of molecules. So the molecules are closely packed to each other or together. Why? They have much cohesion forces. Now, this one is showing us the solid state of matter. Now, let us get some examples. Mm-hmm. Let us get some examples of the solid states. Now, one, you can think of stones. Stones are solids. When you look at a stone, it is a solid. When you look at the iron nail, the iron bars. When you look at metals, the saucepans, all those ones, they are solids. When you look at books, mention, talk of plates, talk of tables, we have wood, we have bricks, now we have phones, now we have even seeds. So all those ones are solids. So they are in a solid state of matter. When look at flour or wunga, so they are in form of a solid. So it is a solid state of matter. My dear learner, do you still remember what we've said that matter is anything that has weight and occupies a space? And again, we've said matter is made up of molecules, but these molecules are coming from indivisible particles which you call the atoms. And we said matter has three states. liquid state, gaseous state, and solid state. And we've said that solids have definite shape, they have a volume, they have their molecules are closely packed, as we have shown here, and we've said that they have much cohesion forces. Then what are cohesion forces? So cohesion forces are forces of attraction between molecules of the same substance. Are we still together? Okay, now let us look at another state of matter, ebiyika yika. These ones are called liquids. Now let us see how do liquids behave. Properties of liquids. One, liquids have volume. Liquids, they have also the volume. They have, that's why we say njagala liter ya mata. So we say I want 1 liter, so they have volume. Two, they don't have definite shape, so they take the shape of a container. They don't have a definite shape. No gamba, this milk is rectangular, this water is circular, this water is cuboidal. They don't have a definite shape. Instead, they take the shape of the container. And now these liquids, okay, they take the shape of the container, the shape of a container, and their molecules are not too closely packed. So the molecules here are not so closely packed to each other, and they have a less, they have less cohesion forces. Now if we try to give examples of liquids here, one, we have milk, there is water, we have honey, we have soda, there is paraffin, we have petrol, there is beer, and so many others. Okay, now let us look at the arrangement of molecules in the solid, in a liquid state of matter. I suppose this is where we're going to put them. So the molecules, they can flow. So the molecules are not too closely packed to each other because they have less forces of attraction, less cohesion forces. So those are liquids. Lastly, let us discuss what we call the gaseous state. So let us look at the properties. Let us look at these properties here. One, these gases, their molecules are farthest apart. So molecules are farthest apart. So molecules are farthest. They are too far. They are farthest apart. Why? They have least cohesion forces. And these liquids, their molecules move freely in all directions. So their molecules move freely in all directions. That's when if I have a perfume, I spray on my body, then everybody in a classroom will get it because these molecules are flowing to every, are moving in every direction. But when it is water flowing, it will just flow in a particular direction, not in every air, in the room. No, but these gases, for them, they do that. So let us see how we can draw their molecules. So here we put one molecule, another one is this way, another one is this way. So this one shows the gaseous state. Now if we get this one here, when we have this one, then here, then like this one, this is the liquid state. And again, the third state, the molecules are closely packed to each other, like this. Now this one becomes the solid state. So those are the three states of matter, and you should know them as we have discussed them. Okay, then let us look at one more thing, changes in the states of matter. Changes in the states of matter, meaning that these states can change from one state to another, and this change of state is caused by a slight change in temperature, either when the temperature increases or when the temperature reduces. So as we said, it's the degree of hotness or coldness. So when the temperature increases, we might get a change, or when the temperature reduces, we can also get another change. So the changes in the states of matter depend on the change in temperature. So the change in temperature, the degree of hotness or coldness of such a substance. So some substances can easily change from one state to another. Remember, what does a word substance mean? Substance means a material that is made up of only one kind of matter. If it is water, that is water, so it is a substance. If it is a stone, that is a solid, it is a stone. So a substance is a material made up of only one type of matter, one state of matter. Now let us look at these examples of these changes here. Now let us take a solid here, then here we get a gas, then here we get our liquid state. Now when this solid turns into a liquid, now before taking this one, let us first get this one. We are going to identify one material which can exist in the three states of matter, and that substance, it is water. Now this water can be a liquid one, and then this water can be a gas, then this water can be a solid. When this water is a solid, it is called ice. When this water is a gas, it's called steam or water vapor. When this water is a liquid, it is called it is called water itself. Now let us see our solid turning to a liquid. Now our water, our ice turning to a liquid, chigiza ice asanuka, and that is what we call melting. This is what we call melting. Oh, when we have our ghee, so when you heat this ghee is going to do what? To melt. When you have blue band, not blue band, we call it margarine. Blue band is just a label, a brand, but it is called margarine. So Prestige is a label, blue band is a label, but all of them are called margarine. Now when they are going to melt, so this change, so from a solid to a liquid is called melting. Even at the same time, this liquid, this water can go back to ice when we put it under in a refrigerator that is free freezing, or when the temperature reduces. Here temperatures to increase, you have to heat, and the temperature increases to cause melting, but here you have to reduce the temperature, and when the temperature is reduced, then it's going to turn to a solid. Then let us look at this solid turning into a gas. And this is what we call a sublimation, and this is not common. Then when this gas also turns back to a solid, this is what we call deposition, and this is unique. And these things which can turn directly from a solid to a gas, we call them sublimes, mm-hmm, or sublimates. One, we have iodine crystals. Mm-hmm. We have iodine crystals that can go under, can go through sublimation. We have naphthalene. Then the best example for you to understand naphthalene, they are the toilet bowls. If you have toilets, zibatulako obupiro obwakalo obwanga sweet, so you call them naphthalene. On heating them little heat, then they are going to turn into a gas. Mm-hmm. Then again, we have what we call ammonium chloride. So this ammonium chloride, especially, is found in a dry cell. Ammonium chloride and others, but at your level, take ammonium chloride, naphthalene, iodine crystals. Even you have solid carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide can turn into a solid. Solid carbon dioxide. And now this one is used in these mobile freezers, especially these people who are selling ice, maybe at a certain function, maybe city festival. Those people who are selling those things, they have mini refrigerators inside there. They have those crystals like ice, but that is carbon dioxide, so it is called solid carbon dioxide. So those ones, they can sublime. Then again, we can take this gas, then a gas can turn into a liquid. Let us assume the gas is a steam, that is water. So omuka gunofuko mu amazi gugenda kuwola, that is what we call condensation. So condensation is the process by which a gas turns into a liquid. The opposite of condensation is going to be, now amazi ofuko omuka, that's going to be evaporation. So this is going to be evaporation. So evaporation is the process by which a liquid turns into a gas, whereas condensation is the process by which a gas turns into a liquid. Let me hope that you've understood what we've discussed here. So let us write our assignment. So our question number one, let me get a pen. Question number one here. So question one, it is saying, what is matter? Very simple. Number one is saying, what is matter? Number two here, it is saying, what is weight? Number two is, what is weight? Then our number three, they are telling us that, define mass. Define mass. The number four here, they are telling us that, what is volume? Simple things. What is a volume? The number five here, write down any two properties of matter. Write down any two properties of matter. Number six, mention the three states of matter. Mention the three states of matter. The number seven here, what is matter made of? What is matter made up of? Number eight, state any three properties of solid state. State any three properties, properties of solid matter. Properties of solid matter. Number nine, which state of matter, which state of matter is shown in the diagram? Is shown in the diagram, the states of matter shown in the diagrams below. We have this one, one, two, then we have this one, then again we have this, with this here, here, and here. So this is A, you tell us, this is B, and this is C. So number 10 here, write down two physical properties of solids. Write down two physical properties of solids. Write down two physical properties of liquids here. Let us get another question here. This one is telling us that what causes that a change of state? What causes a change of state? Number 12. Give any three properties of gases. Give any three properties of a gaseous state. Gaseous state of matter. Number 13. Write down any four examples of liquids. Write down any four examples of liquids. Number 14 here. What is cohesion? What are cohesion forces? Number 15. Define the following processes here. One, melting, okusanuka. Two, evaporation. Then three, freezing. Then four, condensation. Name the substance that exists in the three states of matter. What do you call water? What do you call water at A, 100 degrees, B, 0 degrees Celsius? In the space below, draw a liquid state of matter. Why is a piece of chalk called matter? Alright, you've been a good learner. We meet in our next lesson. That will be lesson 20, 24.